Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode, and in this video tutorial I will talk about Gantt charts in MATLAB. So I will go on through what's the difference between the bar chart, line chart, pie charts, which we use most of the time, and what is the advantage we get by using the Gantt chart. And secondly, I will go on through its MATLAB code and I will explain how it works. So without any further ado, let's jump into the video. To move further, let me clarify a few things. Our website simulationtutor.com, and I will put the link of this article in the description. So I have added much more details about the charts and what is the advantages of Gantt charts over the others, and along with the explanation of the MATLAB code. And here is a link. From that link you can download this MATLAB code without any restriction. So similarly, we have another articles, and in that articles we have available MATLAB code download link, so you may go there, read about the content, or you may download any MATLAB code by just clicking over the link. So let's continue. Before we move further, let me explore the basic type of charts. So if you want to explore any built-in MATLAB command, just you have to type doc here in the command window, and after that you may put any command. So let me just type bar, which is actually a built-in command for bar charts. So here is a documentation for that bar, or I can also even search here bar. So this is the bar built-in command. So let me explore the example. So it creates a bar graph with one bar for each element in Y if Y is a matrix. Let me see the example. So in the example, what actually the bar charts, they are used to compare different values. For example, you could use a bar chart to compare the sales of different products or the number of visitors to different websites. So let's move on to other type of chart, which is line. And let me click on line chart. Here you can see. Here you can see the suggestions of about the line. So create this line. Let me open that. So here you can see there are different kind of examples. We can use line just like this or this way. Let me explore this example. So in line charts, they are used to show how a value change over time. For example, you could use a line chart to show the temperature over the course of a day, or the price of a stock over the course of a year. So that's how it works. Let's explore the pie charts. So these are the ways we can use the pie charts. Okay. So pie charts basically used to show the relative parts of a whole. So for example, you could use a pie chart to show the market share of different companies or the budget allocation for different departments. So right over here, the code, you can get an idea from the code how to create a pie chart. Okay, and here there is a section how we can label them. So you when you will click on open live script, you will be into the MATLAB. So similarly, right over here at the end of this, you can get another relevant instruction, built-in MATLAB instruction, that is Py3. So Py3, which is actually draws a three-dimensional pie chart using the data in X. So that's how you can explore a command in the MathWorks documentation. And similarly, you can explore the relevant built-in commands. So now let's get back to our topic, which is Gantt charts. So actually, basically the advantage of Gantt charts, which is actually a powerful tool for project planning, scheduling, and tracking. They are they are different from other type of charts in their focus on time. As you can see right over here, both these charts are type of the Gantt charts. Their advantage is that they focus on time. We can see the task dependencies and the progress tracking, which is not available in other type of charts, and this is the advantage of them. So let's start with the MATLAB part. So right over here in the start of the command, we have three tasks. Let me left click here and start the debugger. So right over here we have three tasks. We can name as per our own choice, and let's go with the generic one. And for each task, this is the start times and the end time. So it means that the task one, which is actually starts from the day one and ends on the day three, and the second task, which starts from the day four, and this task is ends on the day six. So, and third one is start from the day seven and ends on the day nine. So duration for each task, right over here, we have end times minus start times, which means we have 2 days of the duration for each task. Right over here in the duration, you can see we have we have a matrix of 2, 2, and 2. So task one have 2 days, and task two have another 2 days. Similarly, task three have 2 days. So right over here, we have to create a bar chart. Plotting a bar chart with the specific start and end times for each task or activity. Right over here, we started with the bar chart with the start times, which is the number of the days, and it's the duration. Stacked will be used later. So these are the durations. Let me plot that bar. And here are the number of days, and these are the duration. So after that, in this right over here, we are going to add the labels for that. So tasks labels, which is actually, let me click on step. So inside the tasks labels, we have the number of the days and included the durations. So let me open the tasks label. So right over here, as you can see, in the start of we have the tasks, and after that we have the durations along with the number of days. So this is the representation we have done right over here. And right over here there is a mention of yticks. So yticks is actually a built-in MATLAB command, which actually is going to tick the markers or to appear the markers, sets the at the y-axis. So let's click on step, and right over here we are going to use the task labels. And right over here you can see that the tasks labels which we have generated, so we have just used them at the y-axis as the tick values. So after that there is a kind of labeling. There is a y-axis, and on x-axis and y-axis labeling and grid on, and then there is a show of the figure. Okay, so this is the first type of Gantt chart, and we can adjust it further for our own choice. Let me make it a figure. Let me click on continue. This is the first type of chart which I already have explained. Now let me get back, move to another type of it's second example. And right over here we have tasks, we have same start and end times, again calculation of the durations, and here against the each type of tasks we have certain colors for that. So define the colors for each task and click on step. Now we are going to print that figure. So in time scale, we have started with the day one. Again, there is a bar h, which is actually a built-in MATLAB command, which is used to create a array and create a bar, horizontal bar for the data which we have in form of arrays. Let me show you that too in the documentation part. So plot bar graph horizontally. So durations plus time scale and the colors. Let me click on step. Okay, so right over here we have the first color, which is red. So we have duration of 2, which is same for each of them, and the time scale, which is representing them right over here. And let's click on the continue. So right over here we have 3 colors, and now putting the vertex, which is actually the tasks to present the tasks over this figure. And now we are presenting the task, and now X label and the Y label. And here we are doing some kind of scaling needed as. So let me click on continue. Okay, so this X lim is just adjusting the x-axis limit to maximum 10. We can adjust that to increase, or we can adjust that to decrease it to 6 or 4. So that's how this Gantt chart works. And similarly, we can use it in our project planning and to focus on the time and create the tasks, tasks dependencies, and the progress tracking. So overall, the other type of charts like bar charts, line charts, and pie charts are not specifically designed for project planning and scheduling. They can be used to visualize data in a variety of ways, but they do not show task dependencies or the progress tracking. So hopefully you enjoy this video. Please like this video, share with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching.